Joe 90 first aired in 1968 and was the sixth series to be made in Super Marionation.
You know what to do. Just relax.
The show centered around 9-year-old Joe McClaine, whose father, Professor Ian McClaine, had created a machine called the Big Rat.
The Big Rat?
The Brain Impulse Galvanoscope. Record and transfer.
The Big Rat was capable of recording a human brain pattern onto magnetic tape and then transferring all of that captured knowledge and experience to another person.
Oh, Mac, it's incredible, just incredible.
After demonstrating the machine to Sam Luver, Professor McClaine is surprised to discover that his friend is really an agent of the World Intelligence Network. And WIN Chief Shane Weston is very interested in purchasing the machine.
Will somebody please explain to me how this crazy scheme's supposed to work?
Since the Big Rat was originally tested on Joe, and Professor McClaine has only a minimal interest in his son's well-being,
don't come crying to me if you get hurt.
He will now become the World Intelligence Network's latest and most special agent, Joe 90. Each week, the brain pattern of a top specialist will be recorded without their consent and transferred to Joe, enabling him to carry out a variety of dangerous missions in order to preserve world peace.
Smashing!
After the large number of characters that had made up the casts of both Thunderbirds and Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons, Joe 90 would initially seem a much smaller series by comparison.
That's the way we like it, Sam.
Joe and his father didn't live in a top-secret base, but rather a nice, cozy cottage on the Cornish coast, albeit one with a hidden lab in the basement. And although several episodes of the show would include memorable guest vehicles, the only two we regularly saw were Professor McClane's jet air car and Sam Luver's car.
Car? What car?
While this was certainly a departure from what had gone before, and gave merchandisers fewer potential toys to market based on the show, the series made up for its lack of cool hardware by being one of the most character-driven Anderson productions ever made. Joe himself was to be voiced by 16-year-old Len Jones, and was the first little boy of the Super Marionation universe not to be voiced by a woman. But perhaps surprisingly, the real stars of the show were the three adult leads. Rupert Davies, best known to television audiences as Maygray, gave a standout performance as Professor McClaine, Joe's loving but often conflicted father.
I don't mind telling you, I had my doubts about letting Joe work for World Intelligence.
You certainly did, Mac.
While Super Marionation regulars Keith Alexander and David Healy took on the roles of Sam Luver and the wisecracking WIN chief Shane Weston, respectively.
It took a big rat to catch a big rat. Get it?
Yes, Chief. Very clever.
Good.
Although the series centered around the exploits of a 9-year-old boy, some of its very best scenes focused on these three characters and the occasional conflict between them regarding Joe's newfound career as a secret agent.
Are you accusing us of sending Joe on a highly dangerous assignment without your permission?
The thought had crossed my mind.
No,
I suggest you two cut it out.
The show would be filmed using the same correctly proportioned puppets that had been designed for its predecessor, Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons, with the puppet builders and sculptors once again refining their technique still further when it came to producing an even smaller puppet than usual to play Joe himself.
Sweet boy.
And considering that the star of the show was a 9-year-old boy, viewers might have expected the series to include less of the violence and death that had been a regular feature of Captain Scarlet.
Take aim! Fire!
But instead, Joe 90 embraced murder and carnage on a scale that even Captain Black would have admired.
This is Captain Black, relaying instructions from the Mysterons. You know what you must do.
Over here, Coletti.
While modern audiences might find the idea of essentially brainwashing a 9-year-old orphan boy and then sending him out on highly dangerous kill-or-be-killed missions to be a little suspect, it's only with hindsight that the show's methods and morals become problematic.
Forget it, amigo.
Contemporary viewers found almost nothing to complain about, with children taking to Joe's amazing adventures just as they had those of his predecessors, provided they were lucky enough to live in a region that was showing the series.
Good evening.
No.
Joe 90 ran for one season of 30 exciting episodes and was a modest success despite receiving relatively limited exposure compared to Thunderbirds and Captain Scarlet.
Great, Joe. Just great.
The usual flurry of toys, novels, and comics accompanied the series, but not quite as many as normal. And this is perhaps due to the show's lack of memorable female characters.
Blast.
Thunderbirds had Lady Penelope.
F.A.B.
Captain Scarlet had the Angels.
S.I.G.
And Joe 90 had Mrs. Harris the Housekeeper.
Will you and Joe be in for lunch?
For a production team that had obviously recognised the importance of creating a series that appealed to boys and girls alike, the boys-only feel of Joe 90 is somewhat surprising, and may have been another contributing factor in the show not quite having the same mass appeal as those that went before it.
Then what did they do before we had Big Rat and Joe? Just answer me that.
Despite this, the series has managed to remain in the public consciousness, bolstered by home video releases and occasional repeat screenings.
That's good news.
Although often overshadowed by its Super Marionation predecessors, Joe 90 contains all the superb technical and production qualities that made Thunderbirds and the rest such a success, at perhaps the very highest level Century 21 ever reached.
That's strong talk, Wesson. I'm ready to back it up with action.
Some of the very best puppetry and model effect sequences the team ever produced are in this series, coupled with another superb musical score from Barry Gray and some standout characterizations. Having a child as the show's main star has caused many to wrongly dismiss the show as being the most kid-friendly Super Marionation series.
Bunch of amateurs.
But those who are willing to give it a chance have discovered it to be one of the most mature and sophisticated of the bunch.
I sensed an inner integrity, and events proved me right.
Its recent high-definition Blu-ray release has given the series the new lease of life it has long deserved.
It's terrific!
And proven that 50 years on from its first screening, Joe 90 still has much to offer fans old and young.
I second that. Joe 90, our most special agent.